It's Thursday, July 23rd, 2010. This is a view of Riverhurst, Saskatchewan, from the north across Lake Diefenbaker. Approaching Southside Landing on the MV Riverhurst, the largest ferry in Saskatchewan. Nearing the top of the grade above the landing. That's Highway 42 heading southeast to Moose Jaw, 140K away, and that's grid 644 heading down to Palliser Regional Park, about 5K south. The CPR built their main line into this area in 1883, and this was all ranching country until the hard winter of 1907. After that, farmers began arriving. Somebody's having some crops dusted late this afternoon. The old story has it that H.E. Billings, the operator of the Riverside Ferry from 1908, owned a half section of property right on the river bank that he offered to the Grand Trunk Pacific when they were building down from Moose Jaw. The Grand Trunk declined, and after some negotiations acquired the half section to the east. And this is the end of the 335-kilometer long line that the Grand Trunk Pacific began building away from their main line in Melville in 1909. Arrived in Regina in 1911, Moose Jaw in 1912, and got out here in 1916. Probably intending to bridge the South Saskatchewan River and continue on to the northwest, but of course the Great War put the kibosh in those plans. Here's the village's waterworks, of which they are quite proud. Good clean water in the Riverhurst. There's the crop duster landing, coming in from the north. There was a Y that the Grand Trunk Pacific stretched away up there to turn their equipment around for the trip back to Moose Jaw. The GTP also built a wedge of roundhouse here. It was demolished in 1938. The Canadian National, the inheritor of the Grand Trunk Pacific system, pulled the rails out of here in 1996. The last elevator in Riverhurst, former Saskatchewan wheat pool edifice, now in private hands. That guy must be cleaning out the grates. It was built in 1957, this one. Looking eastward toward Main Street and swinging around past the old church to look south to the ballparks. There's the Saskatchewan Cycling Association van. Village campground is right here off to the right, and the grounds of the school was closed in 1991. 10 years later it became Village Square and houses the F.D. Hill Museums, you see. There's the campground again. Somewhere around. Some equipment in a cage. And the ballparks. Yeah, it looks like they got a game going. Batter up! With the closing of the school in 1991, all the kids ended up being bused down to Central Butte, about 20 miles away. And a view up Main Street. This is the Riverhurst Inn. Get your breakfast there, get your lunch there, have a beer if you like. Looking south down Main Street. Sightless. Here's the village offices and the rural municipality Maple Bush offices in the old infirmary. It's see this quite often in Saskatchewan. These old buildings were built pretty well, and the business dropped off, and they were dining. Administration took them over. Nice old Richardson grader there. Here is a cyclist on the Great Annual Saskatchewan Pedal, looking for breakfast. West side street. And a view up Main to the north. Kind of a lot of gaps and facades along here now. And a view down Main. Kitely Memorial Playground here. This might be called Railway Avenue. Nice old false front barn there. Looking east out of town. And around. And if I'm not mistaken, this is the old station that the Grand Trunk erected in 1916. Sold off in 1976. It's a Type F station. As the area began to fill up, in 1907, the rural post offices of Riverside and Boldenhurst were opened in this area. They were amalgamated into the Riverhurst post office, which was established December 1st, 1914. The village was incorporated on June 22nd, 1916, in the next year, and built a two-room school.
He built it. One of the guys here used to work with his son. And he said it took him 3 tries to get the point, you know, the perfect stone to do the point on.
The population of Riverhurst peaked at about 400 in 1922. And there's a peddler heading 20 miles southeast to Central Butte this morning. We'll finish the day at Elbow. Campground on Lake Diefenbaker, about 85 kilometers away. Miller's service station, convenience store. Looking northwest along Highway 42, the ferry is about a mile and a half that away and over the hill. Because the soil of this Lacey lake bed is so productive, a few years ago you would have seen 5 elevators standing down in Riverhurst there. Should mention Fred T. Hill one more time before we leave Riverhurst. The Weekly Courier began publication on November 3rd, 1914, and the last edition came out on September the 13th, 1962. For the last 48 years of its existence, the Courier was published by Mr. Hill, who was also an amateur archaeologist and a collector, and he put all the stuff in the museum for us to see. Wonderful gun collection, equipment, fashion,